Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to online class. In the previous class, we have learned about density. Do you remember, children? The density of a substance is defined as its mass per unit volume. The SI unit for density is kilogram per meter cube. To find the mass, we have to use this formula. Which formula? Mass is equal to density into volume. To find the volume, we have to use the formula that volume is equal to mass by density. To measure the density of regular solids such as cuboid, cube, cylinder and sphere by using the formula. The density of irregular solids can be found using a Eureka can or a measuring cylinder. And also we have done some numerical questions using the formula. Yes? Okay. The maximum volume of a liquid that can be stored in a container is called the capacity of a container. The volume of a liquid can be measured using measuring containers such as measuring jars and cups, beakers and measuring cylinders. A measuring cylinder is a cylindrical glass or plastic jar with markings called graduations. After a liquid has been poured into a measuring cylinder, a curve can be seen on the surface of the liquid. This curve is called the meniscus. Water forms a concave meniscus and mercury forms a convex meniscus. In the concave meniscus, the reading is taken at the bottom. In the convex meniscus, the reading is taken at the top. Do you remember, children? Conversion between kilogram per meter cube and gram per centimeter cube. What are the two formulas? 1 kilogram per meter cube is equal to 1 by 1000 gram per centimeter cube. 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. These are the important formulas to do the numerical questions. Fluids. Do you remember the word? Fluids include liquids and gases. Water is the most common liquid on the earth. The density of a liquid is usually close to that of the solid and much higher than in a gas. Therefore, liquid and solid are both termed condensed matter. As liquids and gases share the ability to flow, they are both called fluids. What are fluids? Fluids are liquids and gases. How to measure the density of a liquid using a graduated cylinder? First, we have to take the graduated cylinder and find it the mass. It's denoted as M1. Fill the cylinder with the liquid and measure the volume. Volume is equal to V. Measure the mass of the cylinder again after filling the liquid. It's denoted as M2. Now, the mass of the liquid will be M2 minus M1. Volume of the liquid is equal to V, centimeter cube. Okay. What is the formula of this? 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. Now, the density of liquid is equal to mass by volume. It means M2 minus M1 by V. Next one is, how to measure the density of a liquid using a density bottle? This is the density bottle. It is used to measure the density and relative density of a liquid. It is a glass bottle with a round glass stopper at its neck that has a fine hole in it. When the bottle is filled and the stopper is inserted, the excess liquid rises through the hole and runs down outside the bottle. This density bottle is used to determine the density of a liquid. When we find volume of a liquid, the mass of the bottle is measured dry and empty. It's noted as M1. Then the liquid is poured into the bottle. If the liquid is overflow, insert the stopper. Now measure the volume of liquid and bottle. It's denoted as M2. Therefore, mass of liquid is M2 minus M1. The volume of liquid in the bottle is V. Now, what is the density of liquid? The density of liquid is mass by volume. It means M2 minus M1 divided by V. Next one is measurement of density of a gas. First, we have to find the volume of a flask is equal to V. Mass of flask is equal to M1. Remove the air from the flask using a vacuum pump. Measure the mass again. Now, mass of flask is equal to M2. What is the formula of density? The density of gas is equal to mass by volume is equal to M2 minus M1 divided by V. Listen here, some substances are there, some are solid substances, some liquid substances and gases, okay, and their density. Substances and their density. Density is in gram per centimeter cube. What are the solids? Wood, ice, aluminium, lead, iron, gold. Okay, these are the solid substances and their densities are different. Next one is cooking oil, glycerin, mercury. These are the liquid substances. their density is also different. Next, gas substances, air, hydrogen and helium. These are the densities given in gram per centimeter cube. Next one is relative density. It means we have to compare one solid and liquid, or one liquid and another one is liquid, two liquids. Okay. Relative density of a substance is the density of that substance compared to the density of water. Always we have to compare with density of water. Okay. Relative density is equal to density of substance divided by density of water. Relative density is the floating or sinking of an object when compared to water. Matter with greater density than water sinks and less density floats. For example, oil will float on top of water when poured in the same container. So, oil is less dense than water. Corn syrup is more dense than water. So, it will sink to the bottom when poured into the same container. The density has SI unit, but in relative density has no units for SI and CGS units. Okay. Relative density has no units because it is a ratio of the same quantity. For example, listen here. For honey, relative density is equal to density of honey divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. It means, what is the density of honey? 1360 kilogram per meter cube divided by density of water is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube is equal to, we have to divide these numbers, we will get 1.36 without unit. Okay, we will get the answer without unit. So, the density has unit, but relative density has no units.
Good morning, children. Shall we do some numerical questions now? Listen here. This is from the book page number 36, example questions. Okay, from the book page number 36, example questions. Fifth question. A beaker contains 262.5 centimeter cube of a certain liquid and weighs 420 gram. If the mass of an empty dry beaker is 210 gram, find the density of the liquid. What we have to find? The density of the liquid. Before that, we have to find mass of liquid and volume of liquid. Okay. First, mass of the liquid. Listen here. Certain liquid and base 420 gram. It means with beaker. Okay. Beaker and the weight of liquid is 420 gram. Here, if the mass of an empty dry beaker is 210 gram. Did you understand the question? This is beaker with liquid. Okay, this is the mass of beaker with liquid. This is the mass of empty beaker. So, we have to subtract from here to here. 420 gram minus 210 gram. Okay, how much? 210 gram. Now, what is the volume of the volume is equal to, the volume of liquid is equal to volume of liquid is equal to 262.5 centimeter cube. Okay, now what is the formula for density? Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass is equal to 210 gram divided by 262.5 centimeter cube. Okay, listen, this is the decimal number. What is this decimal number? So we have to change this number. For that we have to multiply with 10 here and multiply with 10 numerator and denominator. Now 210 we have to multiply with 10 by 2625. Okay, shall we divide these numbers? 2100 isn't here. Here 4 digit, here also 4 digit numbers. This is the big number. Okay, so we have to add 0 here. So we have to keep decimal. Okay, dot. Then when we have to multiply with 8, we will get this same number. 5 8s are 40, balance 4, 2 8s are 16, plus 4 20, balance 2, 6 8s are 48 50, balance 5, 2 8s are 16, plus 5 21. Okay, what is the answer now? The answer is 0.8. So 0.8 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, what is the density of liquid? 0.8 gram per centimeter cube. First, mass of the liquid is 420 gram minus 210 gram is equal to 210 gram. Volume of the liquid is equal to 262.5 centimeter cube. Density is equal to mass by volume. We have to substitute these numbers. This is the decimal, so we have to multiply with 10 in the numerator and denominator. So we have to divide these numbers and we will get the density of the liquid. Second question. This is the sixth question from the example, from page number 36. 1 liter of water has a mass of 1 kilogram. What is its density? Here also we have to find the density. First solution. What is the formula of density? Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass. What is the mass of water? Is equal to 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram. Volume is? What is the volume? The volume of water is equal to how much? 1 kilogram by 1 liter. So volume is equal to 1 liter. 1 liter. So density is equal to 1 kilogram divided by 1 liter. Listen here, 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. Okay, 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. 1 liter equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Do you know the formula? 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. How it will become? 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. So 1 liter equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Okay. So what is the answer? 1 gram by centimeter cube. Okay. This is the answer. Next one is exercise problem from page number 39. Exercise problem. What is the density of milk if 1 milliliter of milk has a mass of 1.03 gram? Okay, we have to find the density. First one, solution. What is the volume? Volume is equal to 1 milliliter. Volume is equal to 1 milliliter. Mass. Mass is equal to 1.03 gram. What is the formula for density? Density is equal to mass by volume. So 1.03 gram by 1 milliliter. What we have to do now? 1.03 gram by 1 milliliter is equal to one. Here one. Okay. So 1.03 gram per milliliter. Okay. This is the density of milk. Next problem. What is the mass of air in a room measuring 10 meter into 5.2 meter into 2.5 meter if the density of air is 1.3 kilogram per meter cube? First, what is given? We have to find the mass. Okay, so what is this? This is the volume. Volume is equal to 10 meter into 5.2 meter into 2.5 meter. What is the density? Density is equal to 1.3 kilogram per meter cube. What is the formula for mass? Mass is equal to volume into density. Mass is equal to volume into density. So 10 meter into 5.2 meter into 2.5 meter into density. So 1.3 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, listen here. Meter, meter, meter. Okay, so meter cube. Here also meter cube. So we have to cut this meter cube. Now 10 into 5.2 into 2.5 into 1.3 kilogram. When we multiply 5.2 into 10, we will get 52. 520. Here one decimal is there. So 52. Then 52 into 2.5. 2 5s are 10, 25 26, 2 4 2 2s are 4, 10, 10, 3 130. Here one decimal is number is there, so decimal is there, so we have to keep 130 here. Okay, now 130 into 1.3, 130 into 1.3, 0, 3 is 3, 0, 1, 9, 3 things are 6, 1. Okay, one decimal is there. So, how much answer? 169. 169 kilogram. Okay, what is the mass now? Mass is equal to volume into density. We have to multiply these numbers. We will get 169 kilogram. Listen to the next problem. Find the volume of 900 gram of cooking oil whose density is 0.9 gram per centimeter cube. Give the answer in liter. Okay. First one is mass of cooking oil. This is mass of cooking oil. How much? 900 gram. Next, density. Density is equal to 0.9 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, 0.9 gram per centimeter cube. We have to find the volume. What is the formula for volume? Volume is equal to mass by density. Mass by density. Mass is equal to 900 gram by 0.9 gram per centimeter cube. Is it? Now, listen here, decimal number. Okay, 0.9 is the decimal. So, we have to multiply with 10 in the numerator and denominator. So what answer will be come? 9000 divided by 9 centimeter cube. Okay, here gram, so we have to cut these 2 gram. Now balance centimeter cube. Okay, this is 9th table. 1 9 is 9, 1 9 is 9. So how much? 1000 centimeter cube. This is the volume of cooking oil. Volume of cooking oil is 1000 centimeter cube. Listen here. Give the answer in liter. So how we have to write 1000 centimeter cube? Listen. 1 milliliter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Okay. 1 milliliter equal to 1 centimeter cube. So 1000 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, this is the formula. So instead of 1000 centimeter cube, what we have to write? 1 liter. Here 1 liter. Okay, 1 liter. So 1000 centimeter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. What is the answer now? 1 liter. The volume of cooking oil is 1 liter. Okay children, you have to write the numerical questions in your booklet. Thank you.
Children, you have 2 homework problems from page number 40, question number 7 and 8. This is the homework problems.